गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड मेजरमेंट ऑफ हाई रेजिस्टेंस. वी हैव डिस्कस थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ मेथड, डायरेक्ट रिफ्लेक्शन मेथड, लॉस ऑफ चार्ज मेथड एंड मैगर मेथड. वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस द डायरेक्ट रिफ्लेक्शन मेथड एज अ मेजरमेंट ऑफ इंसुलेशन एंड हाई रेजिस्टेंस. नाउ कमिंग टू द सेकेंड टॉपिक, लॉस ऑफ चार्ज मेथड. दिस मेथड इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द मेजरमेंट ऑफ हाई रेजिस्टेंसेज. Now, first coming to the circuit diagram of loss of charge method. Basically, this is a loss of charge method for the measurement of high resistances. So here, in this circuit, C is a capacitor of known capacitance. This V is an electrostatic voltmeter, and R1 is a total leakage reactance resistance of capacitor and a voltmeter. This R is a resistance to be measured. In this method, this capacitor is first charged by the means of the battery to some suitable voltage by putting this switch S to position 1, and then allow to discharge of this capacitor through the resistance R and R1 by throwing this switch at second position. The time taken t for the potential difference to fall from V1 to V2 during this discharge is observed by a stopwatch. Basically, we are observing the voltage drop and discharge of this capacitor when connected to the switch 2. So for this we are having expressions and equations like this. So let R dash be the equivalent resistance of R1 and R connected in parallel when we are discharging the capacitor. If at any instant, say time t, the voltage across discharging voltage is V volt, the charge on the discharging capacitor is Q coulomb and the capacity of capacitor is C, then the current at this instant is given by the expression I is equals to minus dQ by dt is equals to minus of C dV by dt. Okay. And also I is equals to, in terms of resistance, we are having I is equals to potential drop across R dash divided by R dash, which is equals to V by R dash. Okay, comparing these two equation of current, we are having V divided by R dash is equals to minus of C dV by dt. By differentiating this equation, we are having dV by V in left hand side and is equals to minus of dt divided by C R dash. So this is the expression by rearranging this equation, this, and by now integrating both the side by both of the side. Here in left hand side we are having integrating our voltage from V1 to V2, and in right hand side we are integrating the time from 0 to t. Now integration of 1 by v is equals to log e capital V, and which is equals to here minus of t divided by C R dash. Now putting the value of lower and upper integrating values, we are having log e V2 by V1 is equals to minus t divided by C R dash. We are having V2 by V1 is equals to e minus of t divided by C R dash. We have taken the anti log of that. Now V2 is equals to V1 e minus of t divided by C R dash. From the equation 3.56, we are having our value of r dash, this is equals to minus of t divided by c log e v2 by v1. So the value of our resistance r dash, which is a parallel combination of r1 and r, is equals to t divided by c log e v1 minus v1 divided by v2. We have interchanged the value of v1 and v2, so this negative sign is cancelled out. Our r dash is equals to 0.4343 t divided by c log 10 v1 by v2. We have converted this log e into log 10. Now from the equation, this 3.59, it is obvious that if t, c, v1 and v2 are known, then r dash can be determined from this values, these four values. Now from our equation of 3.58, this we can draw our exponential graph of v2 across v2 by time t. So here is the intercept of v1. V2 is equals to v1 e minus of in power minus of t divided by c r dash. So here v1 is the intercept and this is exponentially decreasing graph. Here we have having a second diagram also. So from equation 3.59, where we are having the value of r dash, the test is then repeated with the unknown resistance r disconnected. The capacitor is being discharged through r1 only, and the value of leakage resistance r1 can also be determined in another way also, by discharging the capacitor by only through r1. And knowing the values of r dash and r1, we can solve the value of our unknown resistance, where we are having 1 by r is equals to 1 by r dash minus of 1 by r1. So we are having two types of procedure for having our unknown resistance. In first case, we are going to discharge our resistance across the equivalent resistance of r and r dash. R and R1, which is equals to R dash, and in second procedure we are going to discharge a capacitor through R1 only, and finally we'll get our value of our unknown resistance. So while measuring the insulation resistance of a cable or a capacitor, the test need not to be repeated. In this case, C will be capacitance of a cable or a capacitor under test for determining any kind of capacitor, okay, so which must be known and may be determined by any method if not known. R1 will be the insulation resistance to be measured, so the no external resistance is to be inserted in the circuit. The value of R1 then can be obtained directly from the expression, this V2 is equals to V1 e in power t minus t divided by CR. We are having directly R in place of R dash here, and V1 is a voltage at the start instant of the discharging, and V2 is a voltage across the object under the test after some time t seconds. This whole procedure is for the insulation resistance of a cable or a capacitor. So in this case, we are not going to repeat the second procedure again. So here, this is all about the loss of charge method. In next lecture, we'll going to study the Maguire method as a part of measurement of high resistance. For any query related to this topic, you can write me. Lecture notes will be provided to the college website, and all the combined notes of this chapter, measurement of resistance, is uploaded on our Google Classroom. Till then, continue our lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.